This is 16th June English video session for class 10. We are going into the new topic. It is from the first slide, topic 2, lesson on data. First, before I begin the lesson, I want you to know the meaning of the word apathy. You would have heard this word n number of times. What is apathy? Without seeing any material, can you guess what it could be? What could this word apathy mean? Next, oppression. Apathy, oppression. Again, I am getting to the word apathy is nothing but the policy of segregation or separating or secluding people based on their race. Okay, policy of separating people, human beings based on color and creed, all these things of separation, segregating is called apartheid. Okay, and what is the role of Nelson Mandela in it? Is extreme, he was the one who fought against this apartheid. Oppression, people who are oppressed, who are suppressed. Oppression means suppressed. Before learning, getting into this, let us understand the meaning of these two words and then get into it. Now, this is a very famous place which you all know, Nelson Mandela. Now, about the author, let us learn a few. Nelson Rolihlahla Mandela was born in Transkei, South Africa, July 18, 1980. His father was Henry of Tembu tribe. Mandela himself was educated at the University College of Fourth Air and University of Witwatersrand, where he studied law. So he is a law graduate. From this we understand. Next, he joined the African National Congress. Okay, where did he join? African National Congress in 1944, and was engaged in the resistance against the ruling national party's apathy policies. What is that? This separation, segregation, this separation of people based on the race was the one which he was fighting against after 1948. He went on a trial for treason 1961. Then also, after the banning of ANC, the ANC grew very much because of its ideas and because of its fight against the ruling. In 1960, at that time, whoever was ruling, they banned the African National Congress in 1960. Nelson Mandela argued for the setting up of a military wing within the ANC. So they wanted to have their own military setup. In June 1961, the ANC executive considered his proposal to use violent tactics and agreed that those members who wished to involve themselves in Mandela's campaign would not be stopped from doing so by the ANC. Next. This led to the formation of VCZV. Mandela was arrested in 1962 and sentenced to 5 years imprisonment with hard labor. The amount of punishments which these people undergo in the prison is one cannot even bear to hear. That is the level of torture they come to. In 1963, when many fellow leaders of ANC and Umkhonto VCZV were arrested, Mandela was brought to stand trial in them for plotting to overthrow the government by violence. His constant fight was against the apathy and the policy of apathy that the then ruling government had on the people. The statement from the top received considerable international publicity. On June 12, 1964, 8 of the accused involved in Mandela were sentenced to life in prison. When the government felt, then the ruling government felt that his powers are growing and his members, some of the members associated with Mandela, are increasing in their popularity. They felt that it's better we put them in the life imprisonment. That is how we call the sentence to life imprisonment. Look at the period 1964 to 1982. The majority of his life period had been inside the prison only. He was incarcerated at Robben Island Prison off Cape Town. Thereafter, he was at Portsmouth Prison nearby on the mainland. These are the places where he was spending his full lifetime imprisonment. Next. During his years in prison, Nelson Mandela's reputation grew steadily because his ideas against the apartheid and got a worldwide popularity, and he became very popular. He was widely accepted as the most significant black leader in South Africa and became the potent symbol of resistance as the anti-apartheid. The most important thing the Mandela wanted to do is to dissolve the apartheid policy. That is his main intention. The main is different. Once the apartheid policy is dissolved, then everything comes to a normalcy. All human beings must be treated equal. There should not be any separation among human beings, considering races as the condition. Anti-apartheid movement, he had mentioned, he consistently refused to compromise. They engaged in a lot of compromise activities like bribing, all these things. Compromise his political position to obtain his power. He never listened to anything. He maintained his stand that the apartheid policy must be dissolved.
First
also guilty, having sworn in as the president, first black president. He gave an elaborate speech also on that day. Moreover, he remembers the struggle for freedom and those who contributed to it. At the same time, he talks about his perception of freedom as a child and as a citizen of the country. So, he remembers the struggle for freedom. See, this particular freedom which the South African people have got against apartheid, it's not easy. There are any number of people who have lost their life, many have been injured, and they have been morally, they have gone down, but they never gave up. They still continue to fight against the apartheid policy. Okay, at the same time, he talks about his perception of freedom as a child and as a citizen. So, how was this child? When we are raising children, when we are seeing things, we accept everything. Then as we grow, we start questioning. When our knowledge increases, we start questioning. Okay? Yes. Let us look at the things mentioned in the next chapter. Next. Celebration. Celebration is a place where something good is happening and where many people are gathered. It's something to be remembered and remarkable. Celebration. South Africa was freed of apartheid. No longer we have apartheid. After a constant struggle for over 8 decades, not one day, 2 days, South Africa has been fighting for 8 decades, 80 years, and National Mandela, who had emerged as an undisputed leader. Undisputed, there is no, a sort of division, like he's having a different. This person having a different opinion. Everywhere it is the same. What it is, an undisputed leader. Nobody had anything against this of struggle and statesman was sworn in, taking the responsibility of being the first black president. Sworn in as the first black president of the country on 10th May 1994. This occasion is called the inauguration. Inauguration, the inauguration. Maybe they have come across many inaugurations, but this no inauguration because this morning in and apparently freed South Africa. It's the most important day in the history of South Africa. 10th May. Next. See here, the place, the amphitheater. Look at the amphitheater. What is the most important thing in an amphitheater? It doesn't have a roof. It's a very vast space is there and seating arrangements will be there. It doesn't have a roof. If we ask for, we have an amphitheater, we have an event conducted in that place. It doesn't have a roof. Auditorium covered. Another stage event, it will be covered. But here, amphitheater doesn't have a roof. It will be open. The ceremonies of the inauguration took place in a lovely sandstone amphitheater. What is this entire amphitheater made up of? Sandstone, formed by the Union Buildings in Pretoria. Where was it made? Where was it? The place is at Pretoria. Okay? Yes. Please have a look at the pictures, how the amphitheater looks, the place where President, the first black President of South Africa was sworn in, anti-apartheid, fought against the anti-apartheid. Look at the number of, I think the entire population of South Africa was here. The large multitude assembled in the amphitheater. Why? To witness the swearing in ceremony of the first black president in South Africa. Yes, you see here the swearing ceremony. This is the last white president, de Klerk. Okay, instrumental in bringing about the end of the apartheid was sworn in the second deputy president. Since he was already being bullied, he was giving this situation, this position of second deputy president. But the entire rules were with the who? President. Nelson Mandela, the first black president, okay, of South Africa. Is it okay? Yes, we shall continue the remaining in the next class. Before coming, getting into your next class, make sure that you do a repeated reading of the entire text and take the essence of it and mark the best the lines which are really remarkable. Find out the meanings of the difficult words and then sit for the next class. Keep the notebook next to you so that you find it easy to continue.